I said, they're going through the motions, some cats. And remember, man, the phone, the video games, the cats that live at home, and they got, you know.
What age group do you think is getting stuck on that? Obviously the youngsters, but like, what's the oldest you've seen somebody like, damn, you be in a video
fell off? Or,
well, I don't think got an age limit.
I don't think so. No. I'm saying
50-year-olds, 40-year-olds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because what I think it is, I think the people that, like, in our era, the motherfuckers that didn't get shit, didn't have shit, didn't want shit, now they're like, fuck, now I could just rely on that shit now. You know what I'm saying? I can just fall on, I can stay in the house and hit up this bitch. She don't know what I look like. Yeah. I can sit here and play video games. So there's no age bracket. Mm. You ain't got no drive. It's just something to do.
Yeah, people are, they're replacing their, it's like.
Their real social life with social media?
Yeah, exactly. So.
Like they said, it's not on you, it's in you. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay. It was crazy. I was listening to a podcast or reading an article about that, and it's like people are replacing reality with fiction. Mm. And whether you are just scrolling just to scroll, or if you're playing video games or just endlessly on YouTube, or not to say that, I look at it more like just to decompress. Yeah. And to create content, which is what we're doing. But don't just sit up there and just consume all this content and not take care of yourself and have relationships are important. Mm. So it's deep. It gets deep. But, you know, if you're watching this, and again, Chris brought up a point, where to start, just shower up and get outside.
Basically.
Yeah, just get after it, you know. Have an idea where you're trying to go or trying to accomplish and pursue it. And in the pursuit of that, then things start to kind of happen for you. Mm. And when it comes to getting the girl, it's funny, me and Keith were talking about on the ride up here, but, you know, I'm at a different age. You know, I can't just, you know what I mean? I know how to talk, granted, obviously, but, you know, I got to have my stuff together. You know what I mean? So having a car, having a job, having good credit, having an apartment, having, you know what I'm saying? Like, having those things doesn't hurt. You know what I mean? And in order to get those things, you got to work.
Got to work your ass off.
Yeah. So, and especially in today's economy with the inflation and everything that's got everything going on. So you got to be about your business, man. If you're about your business, get the girl that's the easy part. You know, if you ask me but it depends on the quality of girl you're trying to get. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Cause if you want a real girl that has the qualities that you're after, then you know what I'm saying? Like you have to lead by example. You know what I'm saying? If you're trying to get a quality girl, you got to be a quality individual. You know what I'm saying? You got to have goals that you're working towards. So that's just the way I look at it. And if you just want an IG model or no, nothing wrong with it. Nothing wrong with it because they're monetizing their content. Yeah, yeah. So they're smart. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They know that they got this little window. If they're younger or whatever, and think about it. When a girl is young and they're growing up, they're getting a lot of compliments already off the rip. Yeah. So then they start to figure out like, wow, like my value is how I look. Mm-hmm. So let me make money off of this. You know what I'm saying? Like, why do I want to slave at a fast food restaurant or? Mm-hmm. And again, it's not a blanket statement. There's girls that look fantastic and they work at In-N-Out. Mm-hmm. Or they work at, you know, McDonald's or whatever. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But then there's the ones that go to the gym and they have the little social media.
They put in the work and they do the extra.
So. Exactly. So, you know, I think there's a healthy balance on both ends, but you attract what you represent. So if you want to be a bummy cat, you're probably going to be with a bummy chick. You know what I mean? Or whatever you're into, you know, nowadays. But if you're a go-getter and you're trying to make something happen, then you're going to attract that type of girl in your life. You know what I'm saying? Right. That's just my take on it.
All right. So say the best for last. Last question is going to be how important, I mean, not everybody can get this, but how important and how many points does it move up your level you up again, once again, to have a beard and keep it right?
The beard. That's a big one nowadays.
Yeah. It's essential. How many points to raise the dude?
Yeah, so say the dude's already got gear, you know what I'm saying? Keep his line up, he's fresh all the time, but he ain't got a beard. can it level him up or could it take him down?
It'll level you up, bro, because I just got mine done up and it leveled me up personally.
How long have you been rocking a beard?
Like a couple years now.
Does a couple years?
Yeah, okay. Like three, four years.
You see, like your wife reacts to it like different. She like you better with the.
Yeah, she liked actually. She liked the grungy look. She always tell me she's like grungy.
That's crazy.
And I'll be like, that's really? Crazy. Yeah. But I don't.
You don't feel good. Like,
yeah, be myself.
I like clean cut, uh-huh. You know. Okay. But I like my beard and everything. But she always say, I like the beard look. I'll be like, all right, yeah. So, but I feel it takes you up a lot because you're more presentable. You're like professional. You could walk into the side of business, you know, if you got an interview, if you're going to church, if you're doing, you know, things of productivity and you're talking to somebody, they, you know, you're representing yourself. So, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I kind of rock this shadow, but in my experience, yeah, they like the rougher. They like that. Y'all got the full blown beards, but I kind of knock it down and let it grow back and knock it down. But okay. I was recently in Arizona, and so I couldn't go to my same barber. So the cat that I had, he was kind of lining up the goatee type of thing going on, and you definitely get a different reaction when you got some facial hair.
So if you take care of it. Better for you, clean cut, or better
for you? No, I'm saying I know the goatee, that look gives you more. They like the grown-up cat, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, if you're looking too much like more like a baby face, you know, that may work for some cats.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Like they more in general, majority. Like
I would say majority, like the beard or the goatee or, you know, if you take care of the facial hair. But like I said, you can have a grungy look, but you got to be clean, though. Yeah, I haven't seen it. Now, if you go into the gym, you know, it's crazy. We were talking about that we had a conversation about that. So when it comes to taking you up a notch, yes, having facial hair and taking care of it is a plus. Women like it. You know what I'm saying? Because you look like a real, they want to be with a man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like
a warrior, dog.
Yeah. They want a cat who's going to put it down. Yeah, good word. You feel what I'm saying? So they're not trying to be with a cat who's going to play with it. They want to, you know, that's why the song, Don't Play With It, Don't Play With It. Yeah, they don't want you to play with it. They want you to knock it down. Let's be real. But when it comes to the cat, so you're with a girl and she's clean, but y'all went out on a date. Y'all walked around. You went to the fair or the Santa Monica Pier or whatever. You know, you went to the beach. And that little funk that comes with that movement of walking around, say it's a little hot outside, that sort of thing. We like that. Mm. But the funk that's just from sitting up doing nothing, right. That's a different, you feel what I'm saying? Okay. So same thing, like, odor. It's different, right?
Yeah. Okay.
So say we get cleaned up,
yeah.
Put our little bod or little scout fragrance or, you know what I'm saying, the Sauvage, you know, you get what I'm saying, but you get cleaned up, you throw your cologne on, and you walking around, and you go to a fair or you go to on a date, and you go to a mall or Cabazon or whatever, you're walking around, and you get a little funky from that movement, but you were clean before that. That's a different.
It's more like natural pheromones.
It's natural, yeah. Okay. They like that.
I get what you're saying.
They like that. Yeah. Natural. But just being funky, you sitting up, you didn't, you know what I mean? Like, you just sitting up, and you ain't washed, and you ain't, you know what I mean? You didn't even brush your teeth that way.
Change the draws.
Yeah, draws. Yeah, you had to put the sound effect on that one. But yeah, cats, doing your laundry, man, just doing your laundry is you can meet women doing the laundry.
Yeah.
A cat doing laundry and you run into a girl, even if she got a kid or whatever, they like that. I'm telling you. So the beard is great. If you're taking care of yourself, they love it. So it all circles back. You got to take care of yourself.
All right.